In its opening weekend, the movie God's Not Dead brought in an astounding $9.2 million, making it the 10th all-time highest box office Christian movie hit. And now, in its second straight week, it continues to smash expectations and has brought in an additional $9 million. And you may not know it, but this small-budget film that's getting big national attention has a local connection. Take a look.
This semester, I propose that we refuse to waste our limited time together debating the existence of the big man in the sky. Fill in the papers I've just given you with three little words. God is dead.
I can't do what you want. I'm a Christian.
It's the story of a college student who defends God in front of his atheist professor and classmates. One of his peers he influences is a character inspired by the life of a local doctor.
The character Martin in the movie basically paralleled the life of my own. Pastor Weiss actually texted me with a photo of Martin, and he said, "Okay, Ming, here's the guy who's going to play you." And I replied, I said, "Oh, at least he's better looking."
What happens in Martin's heart is something Dr. Wang remembers well.
So I grew up in China as atheist and during what they call Cultural Revolution. From 1966 to 1976, communist government decided the best way to govern is to destroy the future of all of these young people.
His fate was a lifetime of hard labor and poverty, but a chance meeting with an American professor changed everything.
In 1982, with $50 borrowed from him, with enough money borrowed from relatives, that enough for one-way airfare, that I was dropped at National Airport, Washington, D.C. With that $50, with a Chinese-English dictionary, but with a big American dream in my heart.
Ming worked hard and eventually was accepted into Harvard. There, a Christian professor took an opportunity to influence him.
He took me out for lunch and he said, "Ming, what's across the street?" I said, "That's a car." He said, "What's the difference between car and human brain?" I said, "Human brain is a lot more complicated." He said, "Okay, can you imagine a pile of random piece of metal assemble itself into a car?" I said, "No way." He said, "How about human brain?" So right then and then, he opened a window in my life.
I think of Jesus as my friend.
You think Jesus is God.
I saw the truth and began to open myself to faith. And same thing happened, Martin that opened himself. And there's some overlap of Joshua's character with me in the book as well. In a sense, the evidence that I talk about in the book, supporting the existence of God, these evidence, the words were put into the mouth of Joshua, and he was the one who actually voiced and present this evidence.
Dr. Wang says he finally figured out that science and faith work hand in hand.
Science is about what things are, and faith is about why things are.
Now, Dr. Wang's faith in Jesus Christ inspires everything he does. Just last year, he performed a miraculous surgery on a 15-year-old orphan from Moldova, Maria, who had been blind her entire life.
The surgery was performed November 7th, and with God's blessing, it was a miraculous surgery. And after surgery, Maria saw herself for the very first time. When you really study science to the deepest level, you realize that life's answer comes not just from science, comes from the powerful combination of science and faith.
There's Maria.
And you can still see the movie God's Not Dead in theaters now. Be sure to check it out.